Girls go nuts. This is their CD. Get ready. Here they are, NSYNC. Yeah!
Never thought that love could feel like this. You change my world with just one kiss. How can it be that right here with me as an angel? It's a miracle. Things great and small, you are the one that surpasses them all. More precious than any diamond or pearl, they broke the mold when you came in this world. And we're trying hard to figure out just how I ever did without.
We have never had a band here that while you were performing, the entire audience in unison was doing the same exact hand motions as you. It was kind of unbelievable. Yeah,
that's the one that we choreographed.
Yeah.
It'd be easy enough for everyone to learn.
We bring them with us everywhere we go.
Well, obviously, does this happen at concerts
crowd.
Too? People do the motions when you do it?
Yeah, they sing the songs, they do the motions.
They're crazy. The fans are nuts for you boys. How is that hard to handle?
No.
Gee, let me think. Screaming girls, I don't know.
Have they done crazy things? I'm sure they have. You've had some crazy fan experiences.
Yeah, we've been like all over the world with this gig. So it's like we were doing a gig in Germany and this girl thought that she was a piece of carry-on. She decided she was going to hop on the luggage belt and go past security that way in order to get us, because we were hopping on the plane And she was like, I'm gonna go as a piece of luggage and I'm gonna see you.
Like, security saw this.
Did she get through?
Halfway.
She's our tour manager. The X-ray machine. So.
Yeah. Now, this is your first CD. It's phenomenally successful. How'd you guys get together as a band?
Well, everybody pretty much knew somebody in the group. I mean, these two did the Mickey Mouse Club. Me and Chris worked together, and Justin knew Lance the vocal coach. I mean, through a vocal coach. So it was like Chris started the idea, called up Justin. Justin got JC. I bumped into them. We called up Justin's vocal coach.
It's very confusing.
Got Lance.
Yeah, but you know, you, Joey, look like every guy I went to high school with. Tell me, from Long Island, it's like every boy.
You know, it's Vinny, Joey.
Like, from my high school, you look like Augie Tofano, Richard and Robert DiCiullo, the twins, you know, Vinny D'Abatino. You look like every single guy I went to school with. You're from New York, obviously. Yeah, you're the
Brooklyn.
Only New Yorker here? You
only
see? I felt that. Where are you from, Lance?
I'm from Mississippi.
You're from Mississippi?
Mississippi.
Yeah. And how did you become friends? Just through...
Well, I knew him through a vocal coach. So
right.
This is the only one that I kind of knew of.
Right. Well, you sing really, really well, all of you. You really
thank
do.
You.
And I enjoy the movements, too. I do. Now, Lance, you and I have a lot in common, you know.
Yes, we do.
We both love...
Lucille Ball.
Lucille Ball. I love Lucy, my favorite show. You got a favorite episode for me?
Oh, my goodness, there's so many. Wow, you know, of course, like the Chocolate Factory and...
Vitamita Benjamin?
That would be my favorite.
Yeah, that's definitely the best one, favorite. Isn't it?
Vitamita
do you have
Benjamin.
The collection?
I do. My friend Allison back home. Gives me like all the collection because she loves Lucy too.
Yeah. Do you know that I saw one the other day that I had never seen before with Bob Hope and Lucy was the vendor at the baseball game? Have you ever seen this one? Did anyone see that one? I had never seen that one. It was like a brand new one for me. Have you seen it?
I have not seen it.
I think that's one of the lost episodes.
I think so.
We have an expert in the audience. We'll check during the commercial.
Oh.
Now you guys. Dating, I know the girls want to know that. It's one of the requests we got for questions for you. Dating, I just wanted to...
Well, obviously we date, you know, but that's when we get time, free time, and that's very limited.
Yeah.
Because we're all around the world all the time. So I don't think there's a significant someone that we...
Yeah, nobody's got something real steady.
Mm-hmm. No,
all right, well,
married.
This is a question that I've been asked to ask from the girls in our audience. Do you ever date fans of yours? Yeah.
Of course, sure.
Somebody's approach if you're into the same things and stuff like that. You know?
Yeah.
I think the toughest part about the whole thing is just really getting to know somebody and, like I said, having the time to really get to know somebody.
Right.
So.
Where were you when you first heard your song on the radio? Were you together?
Yeah,
or
we were in Germany. We were in a band.
You were together?
Yeah, we were all in the same band, and we were traveling to some sort of gig, and it was so funny because all you hear is, you know, blah, 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 you know, we don't even understand. All of a sudden you hear NSYNC, and all of a sudden the song went on. We were like, hey, it's on the radio. So it was so funny because some of our, Lance and Justin's moms were in the back of another band.
Wow.
And we had these puppets and they were following us and we were dancing with
puppets,
they were stuffed animals.
And we were making them do all the little pelvic thrusts and things. It was fun. They had a good time with it.
And is it true that it's your mom who named the band?
Oh, no, actually it was
just your mom? Yeah. She came up with that?
Yeah, she kind of came up with the name and she was like, you know, you guys are really NSYNC. And we were like,
good one.
So we thought that was a good name to really describe our harmonies and our dancing. So, and then we were looking at logos to use with the name, and we actually discovered that the last letters of each of our first names actually spell NSYNC.
There you go.
So we said, it's fate, man. We got to use this name.
You're thinking about it now, aren't
you? Well, I am. I'm going, wait a minute. I'm looking for where's the J for Joey? It's not in there at all.
What's
the last name? What's the last?
So there's Justin.
Oh, the last letter.
Justin, Chris,
you could tell I didn't really do that well at school.
And then JC.
Got you. That's interesting. You see that?
You know, we have a few things for you, though.
For me?
We do.
Yes, we do.
What do you have?
First of all, my aunt is here from Pennsylvania because this is a really good story. I gotta tell you this story.
All right, go ahead.
A long time ago, like when we first got the group together and, you know, all our families were like our biggest fans and everybody's like, you know, oh, we'll come to your shows. And there's like, it was just our families. My aunt said, someday, my aunt and my sister, but my sister had to work. She said, someday, the only thing I wanna do is when you go on the Rosie O'Donnell show, she goes, I wanna come to the show. So I was lucky enough that I called her up and surprised her and I flew her in and she's out there in the audience.
Oh, how nice is that? She made me some food.
Yeah, my grandma and my aunt bake, and they baked you guys some cookies.
I enjoy them even more than I did at the beginning of the story now. That is very nice. Thank you very much.
And also, in Germany, this is where, like, we started out. And in Planet Hollywood, you know how they had to, you know, they put the faces up and everything?
Sure.
They put our faces up next to yours.
They did?
Oh, yeah. What funny is that? Wait, we have a close-up.
Well, first of all, Lance is a huge fan of
Oh, yeah, so that's why I got individual.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that. There's my face from Sleepless in Seattle, and there's you, Lance. You and I, wherever we go.
We do.
Well, also, that is very sweet of you. Oh, you collect the menus from there.
No, that's Jason.
You collect from all the menus?
Hard Rock Cafe.
Any reason for that?
I was just hanging out with my friends, and it was when I was doing the Mouse Club, and I had roommates, Tony and Dale, and we were chilling, and we just thought it was, when we roll in there, you know, everybody gets t-shirts, everybody gets jackets. We were like, how can we be just weird? How can we be different? You know, we want something that's original, that's ours. And we used to sit there, and we used to look at the menus, and one day we were like, let's get out of here with one of these, man. We'd be cool, you know?
So what we're trying to say is JC's a klepto.
No, but I mean, you know, so it was just different. And, you know, because it has the name of the city on each one, and now,
Do girls throw them up on the stage?
Well, actually, now it's to the point, where they're like, you know, I talked to the waiter, and he gave me the menu. But now the menus are kind of crappy because they're not
really?
Because they don't have the cities on them anymore. Before, you know, because I was traveling, you know, we've been to, you know, like there's one from Japan, I have some from Thailand, you know, Europe, everywhere. I got them from everywhere, and it's
I guarantee
cool,
you
they have the
right now they are making better menus as we speak.
We also have something else for you.
What else?
Just don't fuck up.
Since we're going on tour, we have leather jackets for your kitchen suit.
But wait, we got it.
Yeah, we messed up.
That is great. Oh, and look, with my name on it.
The thing is, our friend Carl Kanaan made these jackets, and
we accidentally
messed up Chelsea Bell's and Parker's. So Parker actually got the littlest one.
Okay, that's all right.
But he's making some more, and we also have one coming for the charity.
Okay, but let me. Oh, you do? That is so nice of you. You'll sign one for it. We'll put it on the eBay. Let me tell you, save you some money. Only get a new Parker because, frankly, my daughter will fit in this in about 3 weeks because she's on the large side of 18 months. So all you need is another Parker. But I thank you very much. Will you come back later and sing another song?
Yes.
NSYNC, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be right back after this. Don't go away.